Here we go.
Said to anyone.
All right, let's go get our last meal. All right, here we go, guys. Little pizza hot and fresh. Oh, look at that. The lumberjack for my final meal. Oh, savor it. I'm going to relish this because for the next 48 hours, I don't know what's gonna happen. Look at that. You guys wanna see my food pyramid? Here, here. There's my food pyramid. Oh, I love pizza. The final bite, little plump piece of chicken. That was dang good. Mm. Oh, they've got the Coca-Cola truck right behind me. They're unloading it. Ah, there are two of them. I probably shouldn't. I was going to say, let's go jump the Coca-Cola truck. Oh, I got big old cases of Coca-Cola back there. Ooh, I've never thought of committing a crime before. But when you're opening up a big old semi of Coca-Cola, it does enter one's mind. What's going on, YouTube fam? Mikey here, shooting another high adventure video. Heading out to the frozen reservoir, getting ready to start our 48-hour eat only what I catch challenge. I'm excited to give this a try, but I'm nervous just because last time I was out here, we didn't catch anything. I was skunked. The first time I was skunked ever on my channel was when I was here. So the weather's absolutely gorgeous out. Throw on a blinker, why don't you? Like, did you run out of blinker fluid? Come on, people. When did you start driving? What, like yesterday? Holy cow. Anywho, I'm crossing my fingers. The fishing should be better now. The jaws should be unlocked from a lot of these fish. We can only hope. Otherwise, it's going to be a long 48 hours, that's for sure. Heading to the reservoir now, so I will catch you guys when we're all set up. Getting the first couple tip-ups ready here. These are just homemade little wooden ones. Just pretty cheap and easy and effective. I've caught some nice trout on these before. Guys, we got a tip-up down. Got a tip-up up, I should say. Tip-up up, come on. Oh, yeah, yeah. Come on. Oh, we got a bite. Come on. Still there? As you guys can see, there's like probably a good foot, maybe 15 inches of snow on the top of this ice. I'm having to dig down to get, just to kind of clear out around the hole. That's funny, I was just getting ready to add some bells to these. I had thought about doing this and then I also had a subscriber. It's like, you should try adding a bell to your tip ups. And so I was like, that's hilarious. Great minds think alike. There's next to no wind. So if that gets a bite, oh yeah, yeah, we'll hear that. Okay, well that's a great sign that we got a bite. That's a really good sign because from here on out, I need food. All right, we got our automatic ice fishing rod jigger going. I also have another one going down there. So in Idaho, you can have up to 5 ice holes drilled and lines in the water. Any other time of the year, you can only fish with 2 poles. But in the wintertime, you can have 5 lines in the water. I'm pretty excited about this spot. I've got a really big slope. You can kind of see behind me, a really nice sloping bank. One of my first tip-ups is in 5 feet of water. And then only about maybe 25 feet away, I've got the automatic ice rod jigger, and it's in 10 feet of water. Then out there, we're in about 16 feet of water. So it's a pretty decent slope. So it's going to give us all kinds of terrain to be able to hopefully try to figure out what depth these fish are in. It also seems to me, I'm not seeing any other holes around here. So I think we're in some pretty virgin ground here. This isn't a spot that a lot of people typically fish. Normally they fish further into the main area of the reservoir. So I'm kind of hoping that we're kind of off the beaten path and maybe we can fish some area where it's a
some of these fish haven't been so heavily pressured.
Finally jigging my own hole. We're sitting at 12 feet right here. Fully spread out. Here we go. It is time. We need to catch some fish, ladies and gentlemen. There's a bell going off somewhere. Where? Oh, here. We got one. Got one on. Holy cow. Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, he's biting. Got him. Okay, got one. We got one, guys. Oh, we got one. Come on, baby. Come on. Oh, big perch. Yes. Come on. Yes. Fatty. Oh, yeah, I heard the bell. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Woo-hoo-hoo. All right. Look at that right there. Oh, ouch. Stuck me. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. Look how fat that fish is. He's not very long. I'll bet he's about 12 inches long. But that is just a fatty McFattiesville. Oh, the flag didn't even go up. He was just biting it light enough to where it made that bell jingle. I heard the bell, but I was like, why don't I see a flag up? And he was just nibbling it. Moved through the area. Yes. Oh, we're going to eat tonight. All right. That is so awesome that bell worked. That is so cool. I would have never seen that bite. That was crazy. It was just biting like this. And that's all I heard. All right. Yes. Woohoo. Perfect, guys. Supper. We have caught supper. Oh, man. Getting that fish. Oh, that was just the confidence booster I need. I don't have, like, a snow dog or a snowmobile in order for me to be able to, like, move around easily. It took me about an hour just to make the two trips to bring all my stuff out to this spot. So I've pretty much put all the chips on the table with this little area right here. That sun's just about getting ready to go down behind those mountains. It's still going to be about an hour or so before it sets officially, but once it goes down behind that mountain range, it's going to start getting cold fast. Guys, this hole just went off again. The 15 foot. Holy cow. Again, over here, 15 feet of water. Got it. Oh, I missed him. Oh, he was on there. Shoot. That's the second fish. We just caught that last one about maybe 10 minutes ago. Oh, man. This might be the hole we got to be around right here. This might be the hole we set the tent up at. Can't afford to lose fish, though. I mean, I'm glad I have one, but got to make it count. I'm going to put a fresh bit of worm on this guy right here. Wait. Do I have one? Wait, guys, I think I have one. Oh, my gosh. Look at this. I thought I heard my bell go off earlier. This guy choked it. Look at that. That is ridiculous. But, oh, wait a second. No, this is going to be great. No, this is good. We are going to do something with this guy that I think is going to be pretty peachy. Hold on one second, guys. Okay, so this is what we're doing. First off, he was gut hooked. So I just took the head completely off. So hopefully we can get my hook back. This is a little bit gruesome. I can't even explain it. But perch eyeballs are really, really good bait. There we go, just like that. I'm gonna pop that eyeball out, put it on the hook just like that. We'll also put a little bit of worm too, a little fresh worm on there as well. I thought I heard that bell go off. Well, it did. This guy bit. I was just chilling down there. There you go. I've got a little perch eyeball, a little bit of worm. It's looking pretty sweet right there to me. Drop that down. Oh, I got one right there. Come on. Oh, that was a big one too. Come on. I think that was a nice fish. We just got a bite over here on this one again. Oh, that flag. The flag. He just popped up. Popped up. Come on. Still down there? Got him. We got him, guys. This is a weighty fish right here. This is a perch. This is a big perch. This is a perch. It's a big old perch. Oh yeah, it's a big old perch. Yes, yes, yes. Come here. Yeah. Oh yeah. Another tubby. About as big as the last one. Look at that. On that perch eyeball and worm right there. Oh, how about that? How about that? That's another 12 incher, super fat, right in the 15 foot mark, guys. We caught that little itty bitty one, and now two porkers right out of there. Oh, yeah, we're moving the tent over here. It's getting dark. We got maybe about 25, 30 minutes more of good light. So let's go ahead and get camp set up. First, we'll get this tip up back down, but that's called breakfast right there. Woo! Oh, man. Yes. Here we go. Sweet. Let's go get that tent set up. All right. Check it out. Here's where we're staying the night. Let me clean up the glass here a little bit. It's getting cold out. So don't have as much light as I had last time, but we've got our cot here, a couple of sleeping bags, and then we'll fire up the Mr. Buddy heater. Still got an ice hole right down there we'll be fishing out of tonight. I do still have a couple of tip-ups with bells on them out that way. It's so quiet and there's no wind that I'll be able to hear them if they go off. So we're gonna leave it up. We're gonna leave them up till we're ready to go to bed, just to triple our efforts, see if we can get anything else. It's gonna be a cold one. Tonight's supposed to get down to like, I think 19. Then tomorrow it'll be warmer at like 24 degrees. So we're gonna pull up the worm for a little bit. Check this out. Got a little glow head jig. Actually, let me turn the light off here. Check this out. All right, lights off. This is what we're gonna have bouncing around there on the bottom. Look at that. Woo! It's like a little ghost. Gonna be throwing that. Drop that down there. But we're also gonna don a perch eyeball on him. I have something coming up to my jig. And I'm just letting it sit there. Might have to dead stick. I've gotten everything on the tip ups, and that's just straight dead sticking. It is time. Actually, what is the time? The time is 9:30. We're gonna go ahead and clean one of these perch up here. I've been kind of trying to put off eating for as long as I can, close to bedtime. So then that way I can kind of go to bed on a full stomach. There we go. Just like that. Got a couple of nice perch fillets there. It's not bad at all. I've got a little lemon pepper. I'm gonna go ahead and put on those, as well as a little salt. So last time I did an eat only what I catch, I had some people giving me a hard time, like, for using butter and seasonings cooking. I mean, this is just an eat only what I catch. I didn't say this was naked and afraid. I'm sure one day I'll probably make some videos where it's just like, I have to cook everything over a fire, can't use any like seasoning or butter or anything. I'm sure we'll do that one day. The challenge is just to eat what I can catch, what I can pull out of the ice. Using some seasoning isn't really cheating. Now, I did draw the line at coffee just because coffee has like, it's like caffeinated. And for me personally, when I have coffee in the morning, usually I can then go without breakfast. So I felt like that was kind of cheating. But Gatorade and water, I was just kind of like, I don't feel like that jeopardizes the integrity of the eat only what I catch. But there are some purists out there apparently that when you say 48 hour challenge, eat only what you catch, they expect like
loincloth and spear.
Maybe. Maybe one day.
But no, I'm not doing any loincloth on the ice. All right. Supper time at like, what is it? 10 o'clock at night. There we go. Well, that's a little bright, but can't help that. Couple of perch fillets during the day, and especially when I'm catching fish and, like, you know, had some bites, caught some fish this afternoon. When there's action going on when you're fishing, it's easy to be distracted and not really think about being hungry. But now, when I've been sitting in the tent for about, I don't know, 2.5 hours now, 3 hours now, something like that, that's when the hunger starts to set in. It's like, oh, wait a sec, I'm pretty hungry here. There we go. First bite. Oh, man. Oh my gosh, that's so good. Look at that. Big old piece. A fresh mountain reservoir perch right there. Hopefully tomorrow we'll just keep catching fish. I caught 2 fish in 5 hours. Maybe we'll get 4 fish for all day tomorrow. Whew! Alright guys, it's about, well, I'll tell you the time it is. It's 12:05, so a little bit past midnight. Haven't had anything else.
Hey, grab this here.
So, what I've got going on down here, got the flag back down, and we've just got the bell on it, and I've got a little, that big perch eye on a hook, and it's about maybe 5 inches off the bottom, so that's what we're gonna leave down there. If anything cruises by, hopefully it'll pick it right up. Those perch, like those perch eyes. So I'm hoping sometime in the middle of the night I will be rudely awakened by the bell. But I have, let's see, a blanket for insulation on the bottom. Then I also have a sleeping bag that I'm going to get into. And then I also have another sleeping bag on top of that sleeping bag. And if that's not enough, I also have snow pants on, some fresh snow pants that I brought, not the ice fishing bibs, and long johns. Oh, some Adidas sweatpants, that's right. Then I have a long sleeve shirt on, this jacket, and like another Under Armour thing. So I've got about as many layers as somebody can bring. Now I know what a beefy 5-layered burrito feels like. Oh, but you almost have to do it this way, because if you come out here and you're cold. Okay, so it's already difficult to get good sleep while you're camping, right? Okay, throw in 20 degree weather and camping on the ice, then it becomes even more difficult. So if you aren't absolutely positively like ready to stay warm, then it's just absolutely miserable. In fact, you're almost better off just like staying up all night and fishing, because you're so miserable. You might get like 3.5-4 hours of very disturbed sleep. Oh, also, I have 2 socks on, and between the 2 layers of socks, I have those little hand warmer things that last up to 10 hours. So my tootsies are nice and warm. I have gone all out. We've gone all out, and we've probably stayed up way too late. I would really like to catch one of these big trout in this reservoir. That would feed me really well, but we'll have to wait and see if we can do it in the morning. So I'll see you guys in the morning.
Good morning, Vietnam!
Well, good morning, guys. We survived the first night,
which is always a good thing.
That's by far the best night of sleep I've had on the ice. I was warm enough. The 2 sleeping bags, plus the cover underneath me, plus the Mr. Buddy heater, plus the 3 layers we have on, I needed every bit of it. I needed every bit of it. It's a little bit past 7 o'clock in the morning.
How cold is it?
Woo!
Look at that. 19 degrees.
Tonight it's only going to be warmer by about 5 degrees or so, but hey, I will take it.
Go ahead and get layered up here. Throw all of our gear back on.
First thing we're going to do this morning is we're going to get the lines back in the water.
Get everything tipped up with fresh bait.
Did not get anything on our bell last night, at least not that I know of. But that's okay. All right, there we go. Last one. Got 3 tip-ups out. It's so cold this morning. I'm at the hole for like 3 or 4 minutes and it's already getting glazed over. Sun's starting to come out. Pretty foggy on the lake right now, but as that gets higher, it'll warm up pretty quickly. Mid 40s, that's gonna be nice after last night. Woo!
Guys, tip up. Tip up this one off. Ooh, this is the shallow one. Got him. Got him. Got one first thing this morning. Oh, yeah, yeah. That's not a bad perch. It's not a bad perch. Nice. Look at that. That's not a jumbo. Not a jumbo, but we'll eat. Sweet. Oh, hallelujah. All right. Not a very big fish by any stretch of the imagination. He's probably about 7 inches long. But... oh, that's more food in our belly. Woohoo! I was getting ready actually to move this out deeper just because we haven't had anything shallow. Got us a little fish. All right, we have some more perch eyeball to work with. Nice, first fish of day number 2. All right, guys, we are going to hang out outside now. Because it's starting to warm up, sun is climbing in the sky. I've got all my tip-ups and one rod actually spread out from the 7 shallow feet where we caught the one fish this morning, all the way out. I drilled a new hole out to 17 feet. And I've got a rod out there with a big old perch eye and a bit of nightcrawler on it. So it'll have to be something, I think, pretty substantial to eat that, hopefully. I'm gonna come back over here to my hole and start manually jigging. I did get a couple bites manually jigging yesterday, but so far all my fish have come on the dead sticking tip-ups. So I'm gonna have the majority of my rods just dead sticking for me. I'm gonna kind of utilize that method right now, and unless things change, no reason to reinvent the wheel, right? Okay guys, I'm sitting here jigging. I get an indication on the Vexlar that something's coming up, something big's coming up to my bait. And check out what just totally gulped down my gulp minnow. Are you kidding me? Big old sucker fish. Look at that. He's got the jig right in the tip. That's probably like close to 2 pounds. That is crazy. I thought I had a big old jumbo perch on. I didn't have my camera on because I just sat down to start jigging. And all of a sudden it was like, whoa, something's there. And then bam, he hit. And then I had ice around my line. So much for line that doesn't ice. And so then I just had to grab it by hand and pull him up by hand. I get this guy. Well, I have to say, at the very least, I've eaten these before. They don't taste like much, but that could definitely be some food if we have to survive. So better than nothing, that's for sure. So I'll take it. I'll take it.
See, this is what happened right here. I don't know if you guys can see, but see the ice that formed over my line? I tried to reel it in, and it would not reel in, so I just had to hand line them in. Line is supposed to be non-icing. So much for that. You know, my buddy Tyler told me this stuff doesn't work. I bought it anyway. Now here I am getting ice on my line like a goober.
Guys, I think my fishing rod has just fallen over from a bite, I think. There's something on there. Got him. Got him. Here we go, here we go. Come on, baby. Come on. Oh yeah. This is a good fish. Feels decent anyway. This is on that big perch eye. And a little bit of worm. What do we got? Oh, we all jumbo. Oh, come on. Oh, look at that. Oh my heavens. Ho, 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 Merry Christmas. Look, an eagle. An eagle. Check that out. You guys see that? Look, it was meant to be. Actually, he might want my carp is what he's looking at. No way. That is amazing. It's a bald eagle. America. Yeah, I'm sure he probably cruises this reservoir waiting for people to leave fish out on it. That's why my fish are in the tent. But look at that jumbo. Now that is a jumbie right there. Oh. We have to weigh that one up. That is a piggy. I told you guys. I said anything that's going to take this big old perch eye and the worm gonna have to be a good size. Oh yeah. Oh, we're gonna get major fillets off that one. Oh, that's called lunch and dinner right there. What an incredible perch. I'll bet that my biggest perch ever is 1.48. That one's gonna rival him right there. That's gonna be a rival. Oh, what a fatty McFatty's fill. That's what you come to this reservoir for right here. This and bigger. All right, weigh her up. We need to be one, I think it's like 1.48. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, we're gonna beat it. 1.84 is where it locks in at. 1.84, my new personal best yellow perch. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, and can you believe they get even bigger than that? In fact, the record here in Idaho is a little over a pound bigger than that. Oh, oh, that is awesome. And more importantly, that's gonna be some good food right there. Oh, yeah, guys, that's what I'm talking about. Oh my word, that is like just such a massive weight off my shoulders to start the day. Let's see what time it is. It's 10:53. I've deliberately not eaten breakfast just to try to spread the fish out throughout the day. I know I had the other one before I just caught that jumbo, but I didn't want to eat the whole thing just in case I couldn't get anything this morning and like I needed just to wait and eat at lunch. But I think we're gonna go ahead and cook up probably both the smaller perch for now, may as well. That jumbo, that's gonna be like a lunch slash supper right there. We caught him in the 17 feet of water. So I'm gonna go ahead and put another line out deeper and see, maybe that's where they're at, because minus the one little fish in the shallow water, haven't had anything else this way. So check this out. See how deep this snow is? When I step in, look at that. I'm almost up to my knees when I step into it. There's that much snow on top of the ice. So I've literally had to beat paths to each fishing hole here and then there. I'll literally have to walk back and forth maybe about like 8 or 9 times just so I can have a clear path so when I get a bite, I'm not stepping in ridiculously deep snow and trying to bounce and hop and plunge through what is probably about 1.5 feet of snow. Okay, so I was coming over here to move this jig. And when I came over, it was completely flipped up like that. So something nailed it. Must have hit it when I was drilling a hole or something, because I never even heard the bells go off. Thread a little bit of worm back on. Popping back down there. Am I getting a bite right now? Dude, I think I'm getting a bite right now. I'm totally getting a bite right now. I just dropped it down. Got him. We got him. Guys, I just dropped it down. Well, this feels like a good fish too. It's like another good one. What in the world? Oh, we got a big old trout. Oh, we got a big old trout. Oh, come on, baby. No, 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 no. Come on, come on. Come on. Oh, no, no. Oh, no. Oh, it just popped off. Oh. Oh, my gosh, guys. That was big. That was like 2.5 pounds. That's exactly what I've been after. Oh my gosh, she was right there. It just, you guys see that? The hook flew out. I'm bleeding right there. Popped me right in the hand. Oh, that would be even more devastating if I hadn't have just caught that big old perch. Oh, mama! Why me? That is what I've been after. A big trout like that would feed me like all day. That was a beautiful trout too. That had like big red on its gill plate. Oh guys, my fishing rod. My rod. We just caught the jumbo. Oh, something's on it. Oh, something's on it. Oh, something's on it. He's on there. Oh, well, maybe he was. Okay, give him a second. Give me a second. Got him. Got him. Not very big. Oh, but it's a perch. More perch eyes. That's what that means. Whew. Boy, he hammered that. Good grief. There we go. I mean, we probably will end up cooking him up. Just because we can use all the meat we can get, but we're in a good spot. Just what that's telling me. All right, finally making it to a little lunch here. This was gonna be breakfast, but I've spent like so much time trying to catch fish, and then also we've just had like a flurry of activity. I've got a really solid amount of food for today, but then I have tomorrow as well. So I need some more fish to be able to really kind of swing this thing home. It's almost a little more difficult when they're frozen like that. Ooh, that's hot. Finally, my first meal of the day. And it is exactly 12:07. 12:07 and I'm eating my first meal, so. Perch is delicious, but I wouldn't mind mixing it up with like a trout. Cause I've got a little 7-inch perch and that 14.5-inch perch for supper tonight. Check that out right there. Big old piece of perch. All right guys, finally at my own hole here. A little jig head with a bit of worm. And a perch eyeball at the end, kind of staring back at you. That's kind of weird. Anyway, I'm still hoping one of my shallow ones will go off because that seems like where the trout are. The trout always, they seem to be in about 8 to 5 feet of water or so. We'll get my little. Oh, yeah. Oh, he's on. Got him. Oh, he got off. Dang it. Oh, and I lost my shoe. Okay. Dang it. Oh, my. Look at this. Look how slushy it is in there. It's totally lost the bottom part of my shoe. The shell of my shoe. Dang it. Well, darn. Still got bait. Well, we've officially been here for 24 hours. It is 3 o'clock the following day. Fishing's been decent. Actually, it's been really good. It'd have been even better if I could have landed that trout. I've kind of stopped jigging. And well, okay, not kind of. I have stopped jigging. Everything is dead stick just because that's what I've been getting everything on. I have had a few bites jigging, but like most everything has been the dead stick. I have had a lot of people ask me, what happened to your front tooth? And I explain that on my Instagram. If you guys don't follow me, you can go follow me, highadventure_videos. I do all my giveaways there, actually. So I do giveaways, and then I give sneak peeks and behind-the-scenes photos and stuff like that of what I'm doing. So if you like that sort of thing, you can give me a follow over there if you want. Well, you don't have to. It's whatever. It's a free country. Well, depending on where you are, I guess. In America, we're still relatively free here, somewhat. Anywho, my tooth actually got knocked out about 10 years ago when I was in high school.
and the dentist just took it, and it came out, like the whole thing came out. It didn't chip off. The whole thing came out all the way up to the jaw. So the dentist actually just stuck it back up on my head and just said, hey, in about 10 or 12 years, you'll probably need a permanent solution. Well, 10 years later, here we are. And I went in here, about close to a month ago, and had a screw put in the jaw, had the old tooth removed, had a anchor put in. So we're just heading towards the permanent solution now. People keep asking me, like, how did you lose it? And I'll be honest, I've been telling people so many different stories, I kind of forgot how I lost it. I took a wild pitch from Clayton Kershaw in the bottom of the ninth, but we went off the walk, though. I lost it in the sumo wrestling championships in Taiwan in the semifinals. Cost me first place. So just pick one and run with it. That's kind of just what I've had to do. Got him! The things you do when the fish aren't biting. So check this out. I have my socks drying. In fact, I think I need to flip them. There we go. On top of my tent. Always bring an extra set of socks with you, because no matter like what kind of waterproof boots you have and stuff, somehow, some way, water will find its way into your shoes. And then like when it's 20 degrees at night, you're trying to keep your feet warm, it's just super uncomfortable. So I had my spare pair. Now I'm just letting my socks from yesterday dry out and air out, which is always good. If you've got like stinky feet like I do, it's always a good thing to let your socks kind of clean out a little bit in the cold mountain air. This is what interrupted me during my snowman making. That's easily the smallest fish we've caught. Oh man, might end up being a little later when those big ones start coming back out and playing. There you go. Is this here a bell? Oh. Yeah, well, we got one down here. It's on the tip up. Tip up just flipped over. Got him. Holy monkeys, it's a jumbo. Yes! Whoa! Yes! In 7 feet of water. I haven't had anything on this one. Well, for a long time. Hours and hours and hours. Oh! Check this guy out. Yeah, look at that. Not as big as the last one, but he's an eater. A little bit of worm in 7 feet. I'm telling you guys, might have to wait till the evening for the bigger ones to start coming out. But that's a good, probably 13 inches. Probably about pound and a quarter would be my guess. But more importantly, that's some more food right there. Oh, that's awesome. What a pretty fish. I was kind of thinking that over here in the shallow, this might be where we get our trout, but nope. Got a big old piggy. Got a big old piggy cruising through. Yes! Oh! Oh, man. We're not just surviving, guys. We're thriving. Look at that. Look at that. That's all we're catching them on. Just a little nip of worm, just like that. Now let's keep building our snowman. Looking good. There you go, guys. What do you think? Just see some eyes, a mouth. I don't know what I'm gonna do for arms. He might just be armless. I hate to do that to him, but that's just the life of a snowman sometimes. Okay, guys, are you ready for the big snowman reveal? I give you my creation. Okay, so let me explain myself. I was having difficulty figuring out what I should do with the mouth. So I took some smelly fish finder stuff and just squoze a mouth with a mouth. Kind of ended up turning up like it was going to be a dude snowman. We'll put it that way. Well, obviously the pink lips kind of changed that and the pink nose. I was going to name him Sebastian, but I think that name's out now. And now some of the like lipstick looking stuff is starting to run, so it's kind of starting to look like a vampire snowman now. Check out these eyes though, look at that. So I used jig heads. Well, now it's kind of giving him like kind of a mean look. I should say her. I mean, I was originally gonna have that up all night. I don't know if I want that outside my tent now, though. I failed you, Miss Snowman. I'm sorry. You could have looked so much better. But I think the lips and the eyes and the overall everything I did. Just, oh, geez. Well, I have created you, so I must name you. She kind of looks like an Edna to me. I don't know. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. What is the name of the snowman? Maybe the most popular. I'll pin that comment. We'll just go with that name. Maybe a Kim. I apologize to Edna's and Kim's out there. Maybe we should just name her a Karen. She's kind of got a mean look about her. Looks like she's getting ready to go like tattle on her neighbors. Apologies to Karen's out there, but you know, that's just what's in right now. I'm kind of done looking at her actually. Ew.
Guys, this flag in the shallows just flipped all the way over. I just put a fresh piece of worm on it. Just push a press. He's on there, he's on there, we got him. We got him. Oh, another perch. Hey, there we go. I'll take it. More perch eyes. Boy, they're slamming it this afternoon. Not big. He's about another like 7-incher. I'll eat him. Little fatty. Ooh, you are just mad. Look at that. I've never seen him curl like that. He is just, he's even giving me like a grumpy lip here. Come on. Yeah. Not bad, like I said, probably about 7, 7.5 inches. More perch eyes for our rods and a little extra meat there. Definitely will eat that. I could throw that just straight in the frying pan hole.
So I'm looking at this big fish. See how it twitched right there? Because sometimes I'll have people be like, oh, the fish moved. It was still alive while you clean it. See, look, its whole body has departed from the rest of his head. And he's still twitching. That's nerves. Sometimes people don't believe me. They're like, whatever, I saw it move. I noticed something in its stomach. Whoa, look at this. Look at this. What is that? It's like a, oh, it's just a weed. Look at that. It's a mini grub. It's a mini grub. This dude threw the hook at some point. There's some angler out there that is real disappointed. Look at that. Mini, well, it looks like a green grub. Could be any color, but my guess is that would have been somewhat recently, about a little 2-inch grub. These big perch, they'll go after it, man.
Do you guys know what's kind of odd? I have caught fish out of literally every hole. That one, come over this one, those ones, today. But the one hole right down here that I caught the 2 big perch out of yesterday, I missed another one.
I haven't even gotten a bite out of that. I've been checking the bait. I've been freshening it up. It's got the same thing that the rest of these guys have on it. And I haven't even gotten a bite. That's weird. You know what else is weird? This snowman is weird. In fact, the lipstick and stuff is starting to kind of run. And, yeah, it's starting to kind of wig me out a little bit here. Give me those jigs. Thank you. And I think we're just going to... There we go. It had to be done. That was getting a little too weird there. The face was starting to morph. One of the eyes was drooping. And, yeah, it was starting to look something more like out of a horror movie than a cute little snowman. I don't want to wake up in the morning, and the first thing that greets my eyes as I cast my gaze over this glorious landscape is like this demented-looking snowman. So, she gone. She gone. Oh, God. Just had this guy go off. This guy go off. There was something there. Dang it. Oh, wait. I just saw the line move. Got him. He came back for it. Oh, what is this? A whitefish. Whoa. Bonus. Oh, guys, these are good to eat. Are you kidding me? That's a big old whitefish, too. Check that out. I don't know if my GoPro caught that. I think it was at a wonky angle. But look at that. That's a big old whitefish. That's probably about 15 inches long would be my guess. That's got some meat on it. It's going to be bony, but it's going to taste... Whitefish tastes really good. I didn't even know they were in here, actually. So I catch whitefish at my local river. I didn't know they were in here, though. Oh, guys, that's an eater right there. Nice. Sweet. Add to our larder a little whitefish. I wasn't even planning on catching something like that. Sweet! Yes! That's what I'm talking about!
Well, guys, welcome back inside the tent for night number two. Here's the current state of affairs. I am warming my tootsies by the fire. I actually got some snow and slush inside my boots, so my feet were actually pretty wet. Hence the reason you bring extra socks. I also have, well, you're not going to be able to see it, but right up here, I have my pants drying out above the Mr. Body Heater, which the heat is going straight up. So it's actually doing a really good job of warming my pants and drying them at the same time. I think it's time to get cooking. Check this out right here. Look at all that. Woo! That is a full plate of whitefish and perch. In fact, we have that, our jumbo perch on there, the biggest one we've caught so far. So I actually have quite a bit to eat tonight. I think these first couple fish, I've got some Zatarain's blackening seasoning. Top it with a little lemon pepper. Panned blackened perch. It smells delicious. It smells better than it did here earlier when I had my damp, stinky feet up to the Mr. Buddy Heater. I didn't think that went through. Hunger's the best sauce, but that blackened seasoning, that's really good. I'm excited to try that on some like different species of fish, because that... It's like really underrated. I'm really hungry. I haven't eaten in like 8 hours. Tromping around the snow all day. I'm finna eat a lot of food tonight. So I've gone ahead and just thrown the whole whitefish in. Probably should have cut it up at least twice, but I don't know. Whatever. Get some whitefish here. Here we go. So I've been kind of eating it while it's been cooking, just because I'm so hungry. And then that way, as I eat the fish, I can scoop more of it into the pan. You definitely have plenty of small bones, but I don't care. Wow. I mean, look at all these bones. I don't know if you guys can see that. or just a ton of little ones right up here, along with the rib cage. Whew. Well, guys, I think I'm actually going to call it a night. I still have my fishing rod still down in the hole. I don't really expect to catch anything, just because I haven't gotten any perch at night, and I don't know how aggressive they are. After eating all that fish, I'm starting to feel a little tired. Plus, I kind of want to conserve energy. I didn't realize, like, I'm looking at my face now. Wow. Yeah, like, I didn't really see myself in the camera all day, but, like, I'm pretty, I don't know, that a little bit, maybe not frostbite, but definitely some sunburn going on there. I feel really weather beaten, that's for sure. And my face looks like it shows it. One last yawn. Catch you guys in the morning. Day two, we made it. Oh. Oh my God. Oh guys. Tiny bit overcast, which just means it'll probably take a little bit longer to warm up, unfortunately. Well, I slept really hard last night. I think the combination of not a ton of food, the amount of work that I've put into just all day yesterday, and then not getting very good sleep the night before. The only times I woke up was to change the canister on my little buddy heater. I'll be honest with you guys, I love perch. Probably one of my second or third most favorite fish, freshwater fish to eat. But after you've had it for like three meals in a row, four meals in a row, I'm kind of getting tired of it. And guess what we are gonna have for breakfast this morning? Yeah, more perch. Yeah, it's got probably about an inch of ice on it. Oh my goodness. Guys, just like the smallest tasks when it's cold out just become so difficult, like baiting a hook, setting your line. 27 degrees. Well, that's better than it was yesterday, that's for sure. Still gonna be an hour or two before it gets warm enough to where that sun starts to make a difference, though. Oh, keep our ears open for the bells to go off, but start working on some food.
We're getting a bite in about 19 feet of water. Oh, I think I got him, but it's a baby. It is a baby. Oh my gosh, yeah, that's a real babe. Nothing like popping a piggy first thing in the morning. Get out of here. This is what's been bugging me this morning. It's the second one. We're actually gonna keep this guy because I need some fresh perch eyeballs. My other ones are frozen, so we'll just cut the head off really quickly, put him out of his misery, get some fresh eyeballs. All right, guys, we got another one. I think it's another tiny fish, though. Yep. Good grief. This is nuts. Well, guys, I thought this might just be a small one, but... Oh, no, it's a bigger perch. Oh, look at that. Oh, my goodness. I've been getting dinks all morning, and I originally just had the perch eye, or I just had the worm on there. I tipped it with perch eye. Now, that's not a jumbo, but I'll bet that's 11 inches long. And so I was like, oh, another small perch. I didn't even bother to turn the GoPro on at first. But then I was like, wait a second, this feels like it's got a little bit better weight to it. Man, that might be breakfast right there. We might throw him on for some breakfast. But yeah, that's definitely better. There we go.
Guess what's for breakfast? If you guess fish, you're 100% right. Oh, I'm just happy I have something for breakfast at this point. My stomach has to be like, what in the world is going on?
36 degrees. Feels nice. So apparently it's gonna be 50 degrees out here today. I think ice fishing season's coming to a close. Probably be too slushy and gnarly to fish here within the next, I'll bet, 2 to 3 weeks. Gotta go dry out our socks from yesterday. Back to the tent rooftop. Well, it is finally lunchtime. We have 3 hours to go. And I've cooked up some lunch. Let me show you guys what I cooked up. Hold on here. I want it to be a secret. Guess what I cooked? Perch, and more perch. I highly recommend you guys do perch. Next time you do it, do it with the blackened seasoning. This stuff is bomb. Oh man, that was a fail. You know what I'm thinking, guys? I'm thinking I want a big meat lover's pizza with like a 2-liter Coke. Just drink it straight out of the 2-liter jar. It's starting to get warm. Good packing snow. There's a good snowball right there. What should I hit? Let's see if I can hit my fishing rod. Hey, not even close. Well, the breeze has started to pick up so much so that this is where my tent was, but my tent started to try to blow away on me, so I had to break it down a little earlier than I was going to. We've still got a couple hours. Hey, we're finally getting a bite over here. About time. Got him. Yeah. Oh, it's a beast. I'm kidding, it's not a beast. It's a fish! Yeah! These are the Cascade Goliaths right here. That's what you travel endless miles for. I'm just happy to catch them. I haven't caught something in like, I don't know, 4 hours or something like that. It's been nuts. Got a little bit of worm and a big old perch eyeball on there. Choked it! No, we're getting another bite. Oh, are you still down there? Come on. Got him. Oh yeah, a real jumbo. Another Cascade jumbo right there. Woo. Cannonball! Woo-hoo-hoo! Yes! Oh, guys, we did it. The two most difficult things about this challenge have been the cold and there's just absolutely nobody else around. I feel like I got very lucky to catch fish. Come on, baby. Almost there. There it is, 3 o'clock. 3 o'clock, March 5th, Friday. Oh man. It made it much more bearable because I was actually catching fish. I have to say though, today it slowed down considerably. I caught that one nicer fish this morning, and that's been it. Well, I've caught like 4 small fish, but all of that in like, I don't know, 8 hours of fishing. I'm sick of fish, I can tell you guys that right now. There's nothing left to do but go order a massive pizza. Let's go, let's get it, let's get it on. Hi, Miss Heather, I would like a medium, do you guys have like a meat eater's pizza or something like that? Yeah, let's do that one. 20 minutes, thank you so much. See you soon.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Woohoo! Bake that pizza, Heather! I'm coming! So guys, while I was walking back to the truck, because I had nothing else to do, it took me 2,000 steps to get back to my vehicle. Maybe somebody can convert that to me. I'm average height. I'm 5, almost 6 foot. So, I don't know, what's 2,000 steps? What would that be in feet, miles? So it's 2,000 steps there, 2,000 steps back to camp to load the rest of the stuff up, then 2,000 steps back again. So, 2, 2, 2. So basically I walk 6,000 steps. I don't know what that converts to, but it converts to my legs are very sore. That's what it converts to, but.
We ended the challenge as it began, except with a much bigger pizza this time. Look at that. Oh my gosh.
Oh my goodness, look at that. Look at the cheese on that thing. Holy cow.
And an ice cold Pepsi. Oh yeah. Pizza and Pepsi. Doesn't get better than that. What are you doing, man? We survived. We vanquished the challenge. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. And as always, I will see you in the next one.